skating championships. And we're getting set for the warm-up period for group number three of the junior short, or the junior pairs short program. And our own Justin Dillon is standing by in the Kiss and Cry with a special report on Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth, who had a pretty bad wipeout during the official practice earlier this evening.
Skating really comes at a price. I was speaking with Jeff DeGregorio, coach of Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth, and actually just informed me that Taylor had to have 5 stitches, and they're going to try it out. They're not sure they're going to be able to skate. Jeff's main concern was that they're healthy, and, you know, it's not just this competition. It's more than that. So back to you, Mike.
So quite the story. Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth will give it a go. And here we're going to see that call. And Gretchen Donlin will also be skating in this final group. You saw her leg kind of get behind Taylor Toth there. It was from another angle, the fall, and this was during the official practice period. And Gretchen a little bit shaken up as well, but you could see the medical staff attending to Taylor Toth. She was walked off the ice and now has those 5 stitches. They're out on the ice right now with this fourth and final, or the third and final warm-up group in the junior pairs short program. And they are going to give it a go, despite that fall and the stitches.
Felicia also had a scrape on her back. She cut this play or something.
So the latest we're hearing right now is Taylor is trying to see if he can get his feet underneath him during this warm-up period. Trying to make sure that he is mentally ready to give it a go as well. And of course, pairs, it's so dangerous, especially as the male partner holding up the female on a lot of those lifts and having to prepare her for those throws. So he's got to be mentally sharp. And that's what he's testing out right now to make sure that he is fully ready to compete. There we see Felicia Zhang as well, Tanya, and the two of them communicating right now, making sure that they're both on the same page. And again, so important, especially in pairs.
You can see there's a Band-Aid on her back. She was cut as well on the back, on her back. He did a beautiful double axel just a few moments ago in the warm-up, so he's trying to work out the kinks.
We did happen to see the tail end of the fall earlier this evening during the official practice time, and Taylor was definitely a bit dazed out there as we saw the medical staff, which was so quick to respond, and we were very impressed on how quick they were able to get on the ice and attend to both Felicia and Taylor. But he did definitely look a bit dazed out there, and I guess to their benefit, they weren't skating in either of the first two groups and have now had, I think it's been about an hour and a half since they fell during that practice time, so they and kept a close eye on by the medical staff here at the Spokane Arena. And, well, there you see it. Nice little throw as they look like they're ready to give it a go here in Spokane.
Wow, good for them. You work so hard all year and have such an unfortunate accident like that on a warm-up session prior to competing. You want them to be able to be, first of all, healthy, but second of all, if they're able to compete.
There we see a shot of Gretchen Donlin, who was also involved in that fall. She was trying to avoid both Taylor and Felicia, but her leg kind of got tangled up with Taylor, and that's what kind of initiated that fall. And she was shaken up as well, but she seems ready to give it a go. But you got to wonder how that's going to affect her mentally as well, knowing that she kind of was in some ways responsible for part of that fall and suffered a slight injury as well. And, you know, Gretchen will be skating first in this third and final group, so she's got to get out there right from the start. I'll take you through a quick rundown of the skate order for this third and final group. We have 4 pairs. They include Gretchen Donlin with Andrew Spiroff, Carolyn Ann Alba with Chris Kinnearum, Felicia Zhang, and Taylor Toth. And finally, Becky Du with Sergei Sidorov.
She represents the skating club of New York in New York City. And he
favorites coming into Spokane this year. Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth trying to overcome that nasty fall in practice earlier today.
Yes, they're very brave to come out here and give it a try. And, you know, as long as they're okay health-wise, good for them. Great height and control on the split double twist. Here come their side-by-side double axels. Solid, no problems whatsoever. Excellent position up in that lift, lifted back, stretched legs, pointed toes. Excellent pro triple sow. Wow, it almost looked effortless. It was huge. Also be competing in the junior ladies division here later this week. She was third at the Eastern Sectionals to qualify in singles as well. She'll be very busy this week. What a gutsy performance by them.
Well,
good for them.
Gutsy indeed,
Vanya. Excellent.
The crowd appreciating it as well here at the Spokane Arena. That's Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth. And I'm not so sure that everybody in the arena really knows what happened before this event. And Taylor getting those stitches and Felicia getting the cut on her back and just a terrible fall. But boy, did they come back after really... Not many people thought they were going to even be able to compete here this evening after that fall.
Well, and as you said, he looked so dazed when he sat up after he took that fall and the medical team was rushing out to him. You have to wonder, you know, about a concussion possibly, but I'm sure the medical team checked him over thoroughly and gave him clearance to skate tonight. So good for them. Beautiful height on the twist. Look at the change of hand position in the lift. And she's got excellent stretch and point of her toes. Legs are completely stretched. And he lets her down one-armed. And then the throw. Watch how huge this is. She covers so much ice. And when she lands, that skating foot doesn't move at all. It is completely underneath her. No scratching, no snow flying. Very well done.
How'd you feel all the way through?
Good.
You feel good?
Yeah.
Hi, Mom.
You look solid.
Hi, Grandma.
You look solid.
Hi, Alexa. Yep. Sasha.
That's the best. that is over with. Christ's sake, you aged me 10 years tonight. I don't have that many 10 years left.
How old are you?
Oh.
You want to say it.
22, and I'm 32 now. No, you guys are hot. You are hot. Because you rose to the occasion. That's what you got to do. That's what makes a champion.
Yep.
Well, I'll be curious to see what your mom said.
Yeah.
Because you were solid. Just a spin was involved.
Yeah, the beginning.
It really doesn't matter.
No, it really
so
doesn't.
Great. It just,
hey, man. Isn't that that's a statement, Jeff, I'll tell you.
That's the best year.
We're just delighted. We thought we were going to take you out of here. Yeah.
The scores for Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth. The technical element score, 34.46. The program component score, 22.70, with no deductions, for a segment score, 57.16. They're currently in first place.
Pretty remarkable story, Tanya. 57.16, Zhang and Toth, and that will put them in first place. How about that? After we didn't even know if they were going to be able to compete here this evening, they pull off a 57.16 and land in first place, which is one pair remaining.
On the ice from the Skating Club of New York in New York City and the University of Delaware Figure Skating Club in Newark, Delaware, here are Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth.
Now representing the Skating Club of New York and the University of Delaware Figure Skating Club, the leaders after the short program, Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth.
Double twist with footwork going into it. Side by side, triple toes, good for them. Control on that throw, triple sal, Mike, wow. Felicia will also be competing in the Junior Ladies event here at the U.S. Championships. They start on Wednesday. Beautiful stretch on this star lift. Oh, hanging on to that throw triple loop. A little bit forward on the landing. side by side, double axel, double toes, 3 minutes into this program. You know, I'm amazed with their unison because they've only been together since... since last summer. They competed in the Junior Grand Prix in Germany this past year. They were 11th and 5th, respectively, in Poland. So they haven't been together all that long, and their unison is quite good. You know, and I'm not sure all the fans know here what happened the other evening with their accident, but gosh, what a gutsy pair.
And a partial standing ovation here at the Spokane Arena for Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth. They were the leaders after the short program.
And
would need
Taylor
a 90.14 for that free skate to overtake the lead.
Side-by-side jumps so difficult. They go into these side-by-side triple toes. Beautifully timed, beautifully landed. Felicia's a strong single skater, so this can help all these jumps. Here's the throw triple sow-cow. Look at that control. I mean, her upper body doesn't move at all when she lands that jump. She just commands that throw triple sow.
Hi, Allison. I love you.
Hi, Melina. Hi, Kim. Hi, Skid. Bro.
I think it's happy birthday, Esther. Don't you? It's your best friend.
Yes.
I don't think there's any question about that.
Sitting with Ron Luddington, four-time U.S. champ. Bradley in the audience. Always a crowd favorite.
Boy, did he have a wonderful free skate the other day, finishing fourth in championship men.
Hi, Pop. Hi, Grandma.
The scores for Felicia Zhang and Taylor Toth. The technical element score, 50.75. The program component score, 45.89. With no deductions, the score for their free skating program, 96.64. Their total competition score, 153.80. They are currently in first place.
So a 96.64 for Zhang and Toth, and that will be enough to move them into first place with two pairs remaining, a 153.8 overall competition score.